Okay, we're going to talk about the scene editor views within Vizrt 5. We're going to open up a scene here. We are in the Viz Engine Renderer mode right now, and we want to talk about our views. So what we need to do is come up into our workspace drop down here, and we want to select views. And when we do that, it's going to open up three additional windows here. So the scene editor allows us to get a better overview of an object or objects within a scene, and it helps us visualize their position in relation to the lights and cameras and other objects within the scenes. So essentially, these three views have the same functionality and let you do the same operations as anything that's possible within the scene editor window here. In addition, each one of these views can be set to view from a different camera. So within our scene editor, if we click the little number one button, our number one tells us that camera one is active within the scene. And we can come over into our views and click on the same button here, and it tells us which one is currently active. And here you can see our top view has the front active, our second view here has the back active, and our third view here has the left active. At any time, you can change it. So if you want to switch this view to top, or bottom, or right, or left, front, back, or any one of the 1 through 16 cameras that we can. Same for this one, we can set it to any setting that we want within the view here and use the camera that we want to view it from. Now, when you're in these windows, you can click and drag things, so you can still click on any object in here and drag it. If you want to zoom in or out, you can use the Z key to zoom in, you can use the X key to zoom out. So pretty much all of these buttons on the left hand within our views correspond or match the buttons that are in our scene editor window. Now the views can be helpful to see where your camera is in comparison to other objects within the scene. So we could highlight our camera here and then reposition our camera and or drag it within one of our handles here. Now the views can be accessed no matter which render device you're in. So if we are in Viz Engine Render, we can access it. If we close this scene, we can go back into our default view. We'll close this scene, and then we can even open up a classic scene to view it as well. And if we go into the views within our classic scene, again, we get the same buttons and we're able to switch our cameras. And again, this will show us our relation to the different objects within our scene. So if we come in and we select our camera, we can come in then to one of our views and click and drag this camera around as well. If we want to go to our top view and click and drag the camera, we can drag this around to see where everything is within relation to our other objects within the scene. What's more, this panel can be detached, so you can drag it out and put it anywhere you want. And then you, again, can follow your little interface prompts here to place it wherever you want again. Now, to show you what some of these buttons on the side do, we're going to, again, close this scene and open up another scene here just to see it. And when we open up the scene and go back into the views, we now have this button active here. And we can click on this button, and this gives us our adaptive graphic views. So we could even change this to a different view. Here's our mobile view within our adaptive graphics, and then we could change this one to another view. This is a square dimension view, which we can change. So not only can we look at the scene through the views, but we can look at different aspect ratios that we have up, set up for the scene. Now each view has its own set of buttons that you can use. So we can view the key on or off for every view here. We also have an option for the wireframe. So we can turn the wireframe on and or off for every view that we have as well. There's a default lighting setting here. So if we were in the Viz Engine Renderer mode at the moment, we could set this to the default lighting. And this is our bounding box. We can turn this bounding box on or off for each view. And you can see when we do that currently, our camera one is selected. So as we turn the bounding box on or off within our left view here, our camera gets hidden because the bounding box is right now telling us that the camera is active. We also have a performance meter for each view here. You could turn on the performance to see what the performance is in each size of these graphics. And then finally here we have our grid. So we could turn our grid on or off for each one of these views as well. And if you need to know what the grids do, you can check out the scene editor window video.